how's it going? Good shit. Are you under a lot of pressure?
Remain standing for the invocation. this great land and for your hand in its preservation. We thank you for those who have gone before and have shown us the value of standing for righteous principles. We ask your help in keeping our enthusiasm and our devotion to our children's hospitals. May all our good intentions become good deeds. We thank you for the privilege of being here today and for the good time we will have together. Amen.
Amen.
Flag ceremony.
stewards for doing a great job. I want to thank the Legion of Honor for being our honor guard today. Thank you very much, guys. And I would like to thank the Right Worshipful Grandmaster Jay Smith and officers for making time in their very busy schedule to attend this breakfast. I cannot think of a better way to express the philosophy, spirit, and fellowship we practice as Masons and Shriners than to quote, "There are no strangers here. You are just among friends you have not yet met." The one common goal we meet under this roof, as Masons, we are giving our time, energy, and financial support to many charities and causes. As Shriners, we devote our time to energy, financial support to our 22 hospitals, children's hospitals, each which specializes in the treatment of orthopedics, spinal cord problems, cleft palate, burn regardless of patients or family ability to pay. In addition to providing quality patient care, we stand proud as leaders in cutting-edge research programs to discover new knowledge about the orthopedic conditions and spinal injury. So you see, Masons and Shriners are of one mind, serving the purpose to help humanity. To my brethren who are not Shriners, I encourage you to take a step further. Join us, it is a step worthwhile. If you take notice, I have, but if you can't out there, but I have a pin on here from 1906 and 207, and on it it says, "Masons help children," and that is so true, just like us. We all have one common goal, and that's to help the kids in our charities. I want to thank you for coming here today. It's a pleasure to have you.
Thanks for your help.
This time forward, past District Deputy Grand Master Jeff Green, please.
Illustrious Sir, Governor Cervonka, thank you for providing me with this next honor. Brethren, nobles, and friends, it gives me great, great honor and pleasure to make the following introduction. Representing the Right Worshipful Grand Lodge of the most ancient and honorable fraternity of free and accepted Masons in Pennsylvania and the Masonic jurisdiction thereunto belonging, Brother J.W. Smith, the Right Worshipful Grand Master.
Grandmaster, Brother Robert Bateman.
Jeff Green, but they're all here. And I know there's a lot of district deputy grandmasters out here and so forth, and I really appreciate you being here. Illustrious sir, you want to come up here before I make my remarks?
Chairman of this event, Bob Gold. Our chief for being also in charge of the haunted house, Gary Davis. And with the right worshipful's permission, I was be allowed to announce our past potentate here as soon as I find him in the book. Hey, here we go. 2005, Michael J. Kelly. Joel Brookstein, 2008. Joel Ward, 2009. William Addison, 2010. I'm going a little bit out of order. I'm going to save the, one of the oldest for last, but a very good friend. Amanda Iglesias, 1982. Harry Ryder, 1990. And our oldest living potentate, a very good friend of this shrine, very dedicated to this shrine at Delaware Shrine Club, William A. Niemeyer, 1979. Bill, thank you for coming up today. I really appreciate that. Thank you. Now, let's, Grand Prior for Grand Master, I have something for you. This is my tie. I already gave you a pin. And this is a token of our friendship. I hope you wear it well. I'll even let you have the hanger. It's called J.W. Smith, Right Worshipful Grand Master with the Grand Logan of the Grand Lodge of Pennsylvania. And on the back, gentlemen, LuLu Shrine, Plymouth Meeting. Anything that you'd like to do with it, it's up to you. Thank you very much.
Thank you. I hope Zembo lets me wear that. Before I came up here, like Deputy Grand Master said to me, what are you going to talk about? I said, I have no idea until I get up here. That's the way I am. I look at the things that are around me and think about it. I never really have any notes. The DVD that showed Elisa and Kate was so inspiring, and really, that's what we are as Freemasons and Shriners. If you had the opportunity to attend the annual communication in Hershey, you saw a young man by the name of Aaron Kelly, who was the entertainer. He was coming fifth in American Idol. But that doesn't stop there. What is really known, and maybe you don't know, is that he actually was a patient, along with his brother, at one of the Shrine hospitals. And I met him 6 years ago when he was 12 years old. And he was a great singer then, and he's a great singer today. I just found out last week that we all left, I guess, a great impression upon him through the Shrine Hospital, Freemasonry here in Pennsylvania, that he has, wants to know how he can join Freemasonry. And to me, that is great. 18 years old, and so interested in what you do as a Shriner, as we do as Masons, that he's willing to be a part of this great organization. I just want to pass that on to you because that is so inspiring, and to know that these young people are so interested in our fraternity. I really believe that they are the backbone of this fraternity, bringing the 18-year-olds in. We need blood to regenerate us and encourage us to go forward and to energize and think outside the box, not do the things the old way as we always did it. And I'm open to that, I really am. Past Grandmaster Sturgeon started some of the things and I carried them through. I'm not going to have a statewide one day class, but I am going to ask every district to have a one day class, because I think it is so important. And if a lodge comes to me and says, I have 30 candidates, I'm going to do a one day class, they're going to get approval to do a one day class. And I'm also going to invite the Shrine and the other independent bodies, if they want to join us or that district in that one day class, may do so. One thing for sure, if you don't become part of the one day class and don't hold a reunion or whatever, but I'm going to encourage you to be there and give a 5-minute presentation, because I think it's so important that the appended bodies, Shrine, Paul Cedar, Scottish Rite, whatever, we're a family. We must survive. We must keep the work up that you saw in this film. If we don't, if we don't bring in new blood and we don't bring in membership, we're not going to survive. Shrine won't survive. Your great bodies won't survive. We've got to keep up with our charities. It's so important for us to do that. And I did something a little bit different. I got tired of hearing that we're North American Masons are ill-informed or uneducated. So I decided that I wanted to have an internet education program. And right now we have had over 100 people take the lessons, which I think is great since it's only been out about 3 weeks. But what I'm going to do in the history, one of the lessons is the history of Freemasonry here in Pennsylvania. But I'm going to expand that. We're going to talk about the history of the Shrine. We're going to talk about the history of Scottish Rite. We're going to talk about the history of all the appendant body, so that anyone of our members can go online, take the lessons, and learn about our family of Freemasonry. It's not enough to sit back and hope that somebody tells somebody about Shrine, or tells somebody about Paul Caesar, or tells somebody about the York Great Bodies. I just feel so important to us that we do the things we have to do as Freemasons to make this fraternity grow. We brought in over 8,000 new Masons last year, and boy, would I love to see that again. Or last 2 years, and I would love to see that again in our 2 years. You can't expect the person, you heard Jeff talk, Brother Jeff talk about, you can't expect the person beside you to do your work. I can't expect, you know, a nephew of mine to do his work if I don't do my work, or my son do his work if I don't do the things. We all have to take the responsibility. We have the tools, they're there. Let's use them. And like I mentioned before, past grandmasters have given us those tools to use. Everyone knows. We talk about the charity, Lisa and Kate. You know, we have a program for our troops, for our heroes, change for our heroes, or help for our heroes. Brother Bob and I last year went to a baby shower held for them. That's a charity. That's one, you know, just think about it. It's your charity. But when I first went there, I said, what are we doing this for? But when I walked away, I had tears in my eyes. And just those ladies, the appreciation they had just for us as Freemasons and what we've done for them, just outstanding. And I've asked Colonel Brooks and Brother Harry Rutter to continue and look at more ideas what we can do to help these people, our troops, while they're overseas. We all have charities. We all have something to do. So let's do it. You gave over $475,000 in the last 4 years to our heroes. Let's do that for the next 2 years and keep increasing it. And we'll all be better for it. We'll all feel great. I know I do. I hope you do. I hope you're proud to be a Mason. I hope you're proud to be a Shriner. Because if I ask one of you who your friends are, up at almost everyone says, every one of my friends is in the fraternity, or most of them. 90% of our friends are in the fraternity, or in the shrine. That's the way it should be. We have great youth groups out there to help, so please, show your Masonic proudness, show your shrine proudness, work hard. Let's get this membership and all the bodies up. Let's just work hard to do that. Again, I thank you for the opportunity to talk to you. I thank you for the invitation, and especially to Lusher Sir Ann. Got a great potentate. He's a good friend. Have a good day. God bless America, and God bless this fraternity of ours. Thank you.